Welcome to the OPAL Tree Health Survey. You can learn more about the health of trees and provide scientists with vital information about our pests and diseases. And this video is all about helping you get involved.
To carry out the survey, you'll need the field guide, which contains the questions, the field notebook to record your answers, the most unwanted guide, the tree ID guide, and a tape measure. You may also want to take a mobile phone or camera, a map or GPS device, and a piece of chalk. If you survey more than one tree at the same location, there's space in your field notebook to fill in the extra answers. All you need is safe access to one or more broadleaf trees and you can begin. It's important to record the location accurately so scientists can find your tree if they need to examine it further. We also need to know which species you've surveyed. If you need help working this out, use our tree ID guide. To measure the height of trees, work in pairs and use the height card in the field guide. One person should take the field guide, walk away from the tree holding the card at arm's length. Line up the arrows at the top and bottom. Guide the other person to point to the tree trunk at the level of the 10% mark. Mark it with chalk, then measure the height from the ground. Record your answers for the first 20 questions, looking for important tree health signs such as leaf yellowing and crown density. Now you're ready to spot pests and diseases in Activity 2. You can find information to help you identify some common pests and diseases that affect oak, ash and horse chestnut in the field guide. The six most serious pests and diseases that scientists need you to look out for are covered in the Most Unwanted guide. Extra information and pictures to help you with identification can be found on our website. You can also download our free Tree Health app for Apple and Android phones. You're almost finished, now you just need to send us your results. Just go to our website and fill in our simple online form. Even if you haven't found a pest or disease, your information will be very helpful to our scientists.
So that's it. We hope you enjoyed taking part in the OPAL Tree Health Survey.